Alright, so what is going on, everybody? I am back again, and this video is going to be a little different than usual. Usually, I make Call of Duty videos, but this time, it is going to be a Destiny-only things that year one players remember. And since the new, you know, Destiny DLC is about to come out in, you know, a little bit over a week, at least at the time I'm making this video, it actually comes out in 10 days from when I'm making this. And, so yeah, I'm just gonna, you know, make all the year one moments that I remember best and that a lot of Destiny players remember, and a lot of my friends and all that, we always talk about it, and you know, just things that the community likes. And this isn't gonna be all the things, but this is just gonna be, you know, some things that a lot of people really liked in Destiny year one, or some things that we didn't always like. Alright, before we get into the video, let me just say one more thing. If you do enjoy, make sure to like, and if you're new, subscribe. And these things I'm going to be saying aren't in like any order. I'm just going to say, you know, just like put them in random order and tell you all about it. But okay, so that's enough for the little intro. Let's get into actual things now. So first up, and probably one of the biggest things in year one, and pretty much most people remember, like if you don't remember this, then I can't respect you as a Destiny year one player, because it is the loot cave. And if you don't know what that is, in case you join a little bit later in Destiny, it's where pretty much this is all you would do for hours on hours. You would stand on a little ledge that I was on, and you would shoot into this cave right here. And you would just shoot in the cave, and enemies would repeatedly spawn, and you would just kill them over and over again, and you would get Ingrams. And you know, Ingrams, they're pretty important in today's Destiny, but they're not like as important as they were back then. Like, people, they would sit here for hours on hours. I mean, I would too. And we would try to get legendary Ingrams, and that was the main focus. And whenever somebody would get a legendary Ingram, it was just absolutely crazy. Like, everybody, like, people would just stop from sitting up on their little thing. They'd run over here real quick. They'd be all happy in the party. And then they would take it back to the Cryptarch dude, and he would give them a blue out of the legendary, because they actually stopped that. You used to be able to get the rares out of the legendaries, but they stopped it now, so if you get a legendary, you either have to get that or better. Alright, but that's enough for the loot cave. But I mean, this was a pretty big thing in year one Destiny, and I'll forever miss the little cave. So next up we have is the small vault, and like, look at that vault space. It's so small, only 15 armor and weapon spots. That's so small. And you know, now in Destiny, they have a lot of vault space now. It's like, I think it's like over 100 or something. It's a lot, I don't know. And you know, that was not anywhere close to enough space that we needed. I remember I used to have to hold things on other characters and everything, just because, you know, it was a really small space. But you know, it wasn't as many guns and things back in Destiny in year one though, like when the game first came out. So you didn't really need as much vault space, but it was definitely small. And it's a pretty good thing they upgraded it. Another thing that used to happen is, you know, when you completed the Nightfall, you would get blue flames around your head. I'm not sure if you still get the blue flames in like Destiny now. I'm pretty sure you do. I just don't pay attention to that anymore. But back in year one, if you had them blue flames on, like when the game first like came out, everybody thought you were like a god at the game. You were like the best player ever. People would like send you messages asking for you to help them, because the Nightfall used to be like extremely, extremely hard. And the Nightfall changed a little bit from how it used to be back then. Like back then, if you all died, everybody died in your fire team, you would actually go to orbit and you'd have to restart the whole thing. But now it's not like that, and you know, you can restart from the last checkpoint, which I think is pretty dumb. The old Nightfall was a lot funner, I think, but everybody used to always think you were so good if you could complete the Nightfall back then. And something else that happened that was pretty important and nobody really knew at the time is Xur actually sold the Gjallarhorn. I think it was the week 2 that Xur came. I'm pretty sure it was week 2. He actually sold the Gjallarhorn. And that gun, if for anybody that didn't know, if you haven't played year one, like that gun, it was a rocket launcher. It was like super good. Like when you would try to do raids, if you didn't have the Gjallarhorn, some raid teams wouldn't even let you play. They'd be like, oh, you don't have the Gjallarhorn? No, you can't play with us. And like this gun was so retarded. It was just really good. And Xur actually sold it. He only sold it one time. And that was the second week of Destiny, and I actually didn't buy it back then because I had the Truth rocket launcher, and I thought that that was better. So I looked at it and said, "Oh, I'm not buying that. Rocket launcher's bad." But yeah, that Gjallarhorn was really, really good. And if you didn't have it, people would like say you suck, and they wouldn't play with you. And it was just it was a pretty good rocket launcher. But by the time I got it, it got nerfed. But that's besides the point. And let's get into our next thing, and that is the Thorn. And the Thorn, you know, it was that little hand cannon, and that it was really overpowered. I'm pretty sure it was two shots if you hit them in the right spots, and then they would just completely burn out and die. And I mean, I used to not use a Thorn at first because I used to be pretty bad with it, to be honest. But I got really good with the Thorn, and it was a really overpowered gun, and it's a good thing that they nerfed it. I know people used to use that in the Last Word, and that was like the main things people would use in Crucible. And the Thorn, it was just so overpowered. It would burn, it would take a lot of damage down from just one shot, and then it'll burn afterwards. That's what made it so good. It would just burn you for so much and take so much of your health away. And it was just a pretty good gun all around, but it's a good thing it got nerfed. But let's get into our next thing, and it's gonna be Atheon. And I remember everybody that used to play Vault of Glass back then, we all played that for hours on hours. It was so hard to beat back then because no one really knew what to do. We were all such like low levels. Like the first time I tried to do it, I was either 25 or 26, and like pretty much everybody I played with was, and it was just really hard to do. Like the first time we tried to do it, I was like, you're crazy for trying to do this. We ended up doing it, and we got like halfway through it, and then we stopped though. It was actually really hard. Like the very first part where you gotta stand on the plates, that used to be really, really challenging if you didn't like have people that knew what they were doing. And another thing for the Vault of Glass was when people used to cheese it on hard, and that was when, you know, you'd get all the way to the end, and then you would have, I think it was Warlocks that you would have to push them off with, it was their solar grenades or something like that. But I know because people wanted the Vex Mythoclast really bad. And because that gun at the time, it was like a primary fusion rifle, I think. It was really, really good, and everybody wanted it. So people would just get on Vault of Glass on hard. They would steal the checkpoints from other raid groups, you know, to go take back to their friends. And then, like, half the people would sit in the back of the map. And then the other, like, people, they would go knock Atheon off. And you would have a really good chance of getting the Vex Mythoclast. People would do that on all three characters. It took me like, it was like 2 months of non-stop, three characters every week, 2 or 3 months. It was so long for me to be able to get the Vex Mythoclast. I did it the cheese way, I did it the regular way, I just could not get that gun. But it was definitely really, really good, and a lot of people spent a lot of time trying to do that. A lot of people probably also remember when auto rifles used to be good. I remember when I used to use the Servo's Regime back in Crucible, and it used to be like really, really good, and auto rifles did, but then it got nerfed really bad, and then they were just pretty much all awful. And I'm pretty sure that auto rifles might be good in the next DLC. I'm not sure, I don't know, don't quote me. But they're not like really too bad in Crucible right now, but they're not like the best, that's for sure. Probably like pulse rifles are a little bit better than them. But yeah, I remember when the auto rifles used to be really good, and pretty much everybody would use them. You'd just be having a whole bunch of Surge Regimes in one lobby, and it would kind of get annoying. But I mean, I'd rather be auto rifles than the Thorn, you know, sitting here two-shotting you and everything like that. So, you know, it was pretty fun. Now, some people liked doing this, and some people didn't, and it was actually farming for your materials, like your helium filaments, your spin metal, relic irons. Yeah, you used to actually have to run around and get those things on, like, the Earth, Moon, and, you know, Mars and all that, and Venus, and for Spirit Blooms. And now you can just straight go to the vendors in a tower and go buy it. But, you know, for us Year 1 players, it was a big struggle, because you used to have to run around for hours on hours just to get enough stuff to be able to upgrade. Because back then, you used to use Ascendant Shards that you would get from the Vault of Glass and the Radiant Energy to have to upgrade your guns. And you would need maybe like helium filament, spin metal to actually upgrade your gear and guns. So you have to have that stuff to get a higher level. And you couldn't go buy it from the vendors. So you had to literally just grind for hours on hours getting the chest and just finding them in the open. And I mean, I thought it was pretty fun to a point, you know, to get some of the chests. But after a while, it got kind of annoying, and I was like, you know, can this stop? I don't want to keep running around. But that was a good thing, I guess. It gave you something to do in Destiny, at least. So that is pretty much all I'm going to talk about in this video for the things that a lot of Destiny Year 1 players liked. And like I said, it's not everything in Year 1. Obviously, there's a whole bunch that we liked and didn't like. But this is just some of the main things, I think. And if you all agree with some of the things I said in this video, or if you have anything else, you can go ahead and leave it in the comments if you want. And I'm really excited for the new DLC to come out on September 20th. I'm going to play it a lot, and I'm going to start uploading Destiny videos to my channel, actually, when that comes out. And it's going to be a pretty fun time when that happens. And I hope you all did enjoy the video. And like I said earlier, make sure to like, and if you're new, subscribe, so you don't miss some new Destiny content I'm going to be coming out with. And hope you all have a good day, and I'm out.